வணக்கம் மை ஹைதர் அலி சையத் ஆசிர்வாதம் சே யுனைடெட் அண்டர் தமிழ் சேவா ஹவ் ஆரியன் செட்டலர்ஸ் இராடிகேட் ஆசிர்வாத மோட் ஆஃப் வர்ஷிப் யோகா அண்ட் மெடிடேஷன் கம் லெட்ஸ் ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் Remember, purpose behind yoga and meditation is to activate our seven kundalini chakra and to get connected to higher conscious. By kundalini awakening, our souls get connected to higher conscious. Remember, one does not need any priestly cult for activation process of kundalini awakening. Priestly cult has no role in Asivagam, the real Islam. Persian Aryan settlers introduced Varna Dharma principle with the help of corrupted elites from black Tamil natives. Persian Aryan introduced Brahminism who stayed in parliament or coil among various native kings of Tamil nation. Remember, when I say Tamils, that refers to all black people living across South Asia. Brahmins of Persia Aryans' main role was to monitor the native kings to follow the principle of Varna Dharma. Remember, it was native king who implemented Varna Dharma and Manu. Persian Brahmins just kept an eye on the native king. Any king who favored his people or went against Persian Aryan settlers' policy would be removed from kingship by the Aryans. For example, Raja Harish Chandra. Control the head and you control the body. Persian Brahmins made new law as per time and condition, which was called Manu Shastra. Manu, a code book to suppress the black native implemented by native kings for benefit of Persian Aryan settlers and their supporting elites. Who are the Persian Aryan settlers? Persian Aryans are children of Cain. Remember, Cain, the first Antichrist. Coming of Persian Aryan settlers on the land of Tamil nation, Indus Valley, marks the era of Antichrist. Tamil nation ruled by children of first Antichrist Cain. In other words, coming of Antichrist refers to Persian Aryan settlers. The art of suppressing truth, the art of hijacking black messengers' name and starting a religion in the name of native prophets with principle of Varna Dharma and Manu and safeguarding the priestly cult is well mastered by Aryan settlers. The arts of hijacking holy books and running their policy of one eye system are well mastered by Aryan settlers. How is this Aryan eliminated meditation from Tamil nation? Koil was a house of elected king. The Aryan settlers under Varna Dharma policy converted Koil into house of Persian Brahmin who monitored on Tamil kings so that the king govern his people by Manu Shastra and the elites to follow the principles of Varna Dharma, thus benefiting Aryan settlers. Priestly cult introduced idols for concentration while doing meditation. Later, those idols became avatar of Most High by inserting some mythology. Meditation was converted into Bhakti Mar and then Tantric cult. Devadasi were introduced in at Koil. Common people rights to meet king or to take active part in administration was taken away. Thus, priestly cult replaced spiritual part of Asivagam with Bhakti Marg of Varna Dharma. Quran or Furqan, it separates Asivagam principles from Varna Dharma principles. After Prophet Muhammad, these Aryan settlers, Roman Persians, started using Muslim label. Under fiqh name, introduced many schools of thought. Many sects under Muslim label was introduced by Antichrist Persian Aryan settlers. Main purpose behind introducing fiqh, sect and subsect was to divide people and keep them confused. Whole agenda of Aryan settlers Muslim organization was to end the truth of Quran, which reminds Asivagam principle. Remember, those who serving Aryan settlers and his policy of one-eyed are rewarded on earth. Remember, life on earth is temporary. We all have to die. But on the judgment day, the rebel would face painful punishment. Quran chapter 15 verse 87 talks about seven of oft-repeated chakras of Kundalini awakening. I read, "And we have certainly given you, O Muhammad, seven of the oft-repeated and the great Quran. Since Quran is the reminder for Asivagam, Here in Quran chapter 15 verse 87 talks about seven of repeated chakras of Kundalini awakening. It says Allah gave Prophet Muhammad two things. One, his seven of repeated referring to seven Kundalini chakras, and second thing which Allah gave to Prophet Muhammad was the great Quran. Aryan settlers, different schools of thought are trying to hide Asiyogam principle of Kundalini awakening, which is mentioned in Quran chapter 15 verse 87. The Aryan settlers, Muslim scholars says that the term seven of repeated refers to Surah Fatiha, which is often recited in short namaz based on Burak Hadith. Surah Fatiha is repeated 38 times daily by 1.6 billion so-called Muslim all over the world. When we ponder on Quran chapter 15 verse 87, we find that Allah gave two things to Prophet Muhammad. One is seven of repeated and other is Quran. If you go by Aryan settlers, Muslim scholars, they consider seven of repeated as Surah Fatiha, which is a part of Quran. I asked to all Aryan settlers, Muslim school of thought, did Allah give Quran and Quran to Prophet Muhammad? No, Allah gave two different things to Prophet Muhammad. One is of repeated, another is Quran. Anyway, it's clear that Allah gave Prophet Muhammad two different things. One, seven of repeated, which refers to seven Kundalini chakra and great Quran. Did you know Surah Fatiha consists of six verses? Come, let's see how these Aryan settlers, Roman, Persian schools of thought tried to make six verses of Surah Fatiha, the first chapter of Quran, as seven verses. One group of Aryan settlers, Muslim schools of thought, gave a number to Bismillah in chapter 1. Thus, by giving number to Bismillah, they made Surah Fatiha as seven verses. Remember, when in all chapters of Quran, Bismillah is not numbered, why they gave number to chapter 1 of Quran, Surah Fatiha? This exposes the lie of Antichrist, the Muslim world schools of thought. Remember, in Asiyogam, the real Islam, the priestly cult are not entertained. For yoga meditation activating Kundalini chakras, one does not need a priestly cult. Other group of Aryan settlers, Muslim school of thought, they did not number Bismillah, but instead they split it verse 6 into 2, thus making Surah Fatiha as 7 verses. Remember, art of destroying truth is well mastered by Aryan settlers, Roman, Persian, by hiding behind Muslim label. Allah himself has taken guarantee to protect his book. Still, stiff-necked Aryan settlers who hiding behind Muslim label, they want to defeat Allah and his religion of Asiyogam, the real Islam, by misleading people. Quran chapter 15 verse 87 talks about seven of repeated chakras of Kundalini awakening. Nandri, Vanakkam.